Hi, this is Sherry at the Intentional Home Podcast, where I share tips and resources to help you live with intention and purpose. This is episode number 2, and today we are going to be talking about how to organize your recipes. Now, if you're like me, you love to browse around the internet and to look through cookbooks, go to the library and find some new cookbooks to go through. We love to find new yummy recipes to try. But it can be all overwhelming. There's so much out there and there's so many good things that we want to try. But when we're looking at planning our menus for our family, we really need to stop and figure out a system for how we're going to organize those recipes. And the first thing that we're going to do is consider the different ways that we can find good recipes. The first way is from family and friends. We all have those yummy family recipes that have been passed down from our parents and grandparents. So that is the first place that you can look to find some good recipes that you may want to consider adding to your own personal collection. The second one is cookbooks. We all probably have cookbooks on our shelves or cookbooks at the library that we love. Look through those cookbooks and find the recipes that you have already tried maybe and you love. Look for new recipes that you want to try. But cookbooks are a good way to find some new recipes. The third way is online. There's so much online through Pinterest and blogs and recipe websites. All kinds of ways, places that we can find recipes. So I don't think the problem really isn't finding recipes to try, but where we struggle, I think, the most is how do we organize those? What do we do when we find a recipe we want to try? How do we remember where it is? And once we try it, what do we do with that recipe? So we're going to look at how to organize those recipes. Now, the first thing that you need to do is you need to figure out a place to collect the recipes that you want to try. So there's lots of different ways that you can do this. Some people like to use Pinterest. They create maybe boards for each meal or each type of meal, and then they save recipes that they want to try to those boards. You could print recipes that you find online, print them out. There's lots of places that you can find recipes. So the next step then is you need to figure out a place where you're going to put recipes that you love and that you want to keep. Now, these are recipes that you have tried, your family loves them, and you want to keep them. What do you do with those? There's different options. You can create a notebook where you can print out the recipes or photocopy them out of the cookbooks or handwrite them and add them to a recipe notebook. Now, I am going to put a link in the show notes for some free printables that you can use to create your own recipe notebook. But that is one option. If you like to have a physical copy, that's one way that you can do that. There's also the digital options. I already mentioned Pinterest. Now, one thing that you have to be careful with, I think, is that you need to have a set place where you only put the recipes that you love and you want to keep. You can't have the recipes you love mixed in with all the recipes that you want to try. It's too confusing. So you really need to have a specific place designated to keep all of your recipes that you want to keep. So whether that's Pinterest, whether you want to figure out a system or a way to keep only the recipes that you love in one place. Another option online is Evernote. I love Evernote and I use it a lot. I don't use it to keep my recipes in, but I know some that do. They create notebooks and folders for each different type of recipe and then organize them that way. And then they have access to them on all their devices and they can pull up a recipe anytime they want. So that is an option. Google Drive is another option. You can keep the recipes kind of organized like you would in Evernote, but you can keep them organized. You can put links to the blog posts or the sites online where you found the recipe. Lots of different ideas, but you could use that option. There's also on a lot of these recipe websites, they give you the option of setting up an account and saving recipes to like a recipe box. There's lots of different websites online that allow you to do that. They allow you to input your own recipes and save them to your recipe box. So if you like that style of organizing your recipes, you could do that. To me, it's a little bit more work because you have to, if it's a recipe, for example, that you found in one of your cookbooks, you're going to have to type all of that into that program in order to save it. So there are a lot of digital options online that you can use. For me personally, I tend to, well, I don't tend to. I do use the physical notebook. And I've kind of made up my own system of how I do it. And what I do is when I find a recipe I want to try, if it's online, I print it out. If I find it on Pinterest, I go to that website and print out the recipe. If it's in a cookbook, I checked out from the library or one of my own cookbooks I want to try, I'll go ahead and scan a copy of it, print it out, and then I have a place. It's probably not the best system to use, but on the top of my microwave in the kitchen, I have a pile of papers that are the recipes that I want to try. So that is where I kind of just throw recipes. And then whenever I get inspired and want to try something new, I'll kind of sift through those recipes and pull one out and give it a try. Then once I try the recipe, if our family just does not like it, then I'll just throw it away and I'm done with it. But if we love it and it's one that we want to keep, then I'll pull out my recipe notebook. It's just a three-ring binder. And I have it divided up by, I think, like breakfast recipes and main dish, like lunches and dinner recipes and breads. I think I have separate. But anyway, I will just stick that recipe in the right section in my recipe notebook so it stays. And that is my permanent collection of all the recipes that I love that I want to keep. So that is my system for how I keep my recipes, but there are lots of different options and you can come up with your own system. So whether you like a physical notebook like I have done, or whether you like the digital options, whatever you do, pick one system. Like I said, you need one place to collect recipes that you want to try. You need one place to put recipes that you love and you want to keep. So whatever that, however that looks like for you, that is the important concept here that I want you to get. Because there is so much information out there, especially online, it's real easy to be overwhelmed and to have all kinds of things saved all over the place and all different little programs and different, from Evernote to Trello to Google Drive to Pinterest. You have all these things saved all these different places, and it can get confusing to keep track of all of that. So I really would like you to focus on choosing just one place to keep recipes you want to try and one place to keep recipes that you love. So not only does it keep everything together, but when you get ready to go make your menus and fix those recipes, you know exactly. You can go right to your to your notebook or your digital storehouse, wherever that is, and you can find that recipe very easily. Instead of thinking, wow, where was that meatloaf recipe that I really loved? Which cookbook was that one in? And then you can't find the recipe that you want to fix. So it's just a convenient way to get those recipes organized so that you can find them when you need them. Now, not only will getting your recipes organized, not only will this make it easier for you when it comes time to plan your menus, but this will also make a wonderful treasure that you can pass down to your children. Having all of those recipes that they grew up with and they love all in one place, it would make it an easy way for you to make a copy or some kind of a digital copy that you could pass on to them when they get ready to move out on their own. So I hope this has been helpful to you. I hope you've learned some things and gotten some tips on how you can organize your recipes. I will put some links in the show notes for some of these different digital options as well, and different places that I have found that you can find some good recipes. So I will just put all those links in the show notes for you so you can find those easily. And again, thank you for joining me here at the Intentional Home Podcast. Be sure to subscribe to the Intentional Home Podcast in iTunes or your favorite podcast player. For more information about my podcast and to see the show notes with links to resources that I mentioned in each episode, go to sherrygraham.com/podcast. Thank you and have a great day.